What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Josh here from Polymathics, the YouTube channel that helps you become a modern day Renaissance man. And in this video, really quick, I just want to talk about New Year's resolutions and how to approach them. And the reason why, first of all, I'm sitting here right now. I'm parked outside of my gym and I'm looking around the parking lot and it's pretty empty. It's 3:15 on December 28th, I think it's a Thursday, I don't know. With the holidays, things have kind of been flying by. But right now, it's kind of empty. As anybody who goes to the gym knows, in the next month, from about this week going on all the way to the first 2 weeks or so in February, there is going to be a ton of people coming to the gym. Almost every year, no matter what gym I'm in, the membership just triples. Like, there's no room for the machines, there's no room for anything. You have all kinds of people in there because they made their New Year's resolution. Now, I've seen out in YouTube land and the blogosphere and stuff, people who kind of are hating on New Year's resolutions. You shouldn't choose one time in the year to make a resolution. You should do it anytime and all this other stuff and blah, blah, blah. Sure. But look, if somebody decided like that they're going to use the New Year's resolution time frame to do something to change their life, there's nothing wrong with that. It doesn't matter when you do it. Like, if that's your excuse to do it, then do it. But the problem, and I think the real thing that most people are getting at with these resolutions is that most people don't stick to them. And I'm gonna use the gym as an example because it's analogous to pretty much what happens in any kind of New Year's resolution. And here's what I see. People sign up for the gym right around then. They're like, I'm gonna get in shape for the summer. I'm gonna finally get that beach bod. I'm gonna drop those 20, 30, 40, whatever pounds that I gotta do, and I'm gonna, all this other stuff. And they go, and they do one of two main things, but it all boils down to like one problem. And one of the things that they'll do is they'll hire a trainer. They'll spend extra money to get a trainer, and this trainer comes in and is gonna teach them the ropes. The other thing that they do, in contrast, is they'll pick some program or diet that they're gonna go on. Now, I'll address that in a second here. And don't worry, all of you guys, this isn't about the gym. I'm gonna tie this into like all kinds of stuff, writing, investment, all that stuff. But here's what happens. They have this trainer, and the trainer is used to teaching people who are more serious about their, and more further along the journey. That's a better way to put it. Than these newbies, quote unquote. And what ends up happening is the trainers, they totally burn these people out. They've got them running on the treadmill for 30 minutes or an hour. They've got them like doing all these weird, strange, over the arm, balancing on a ball techniques, and then all this weird stuff, right? That may not even be congruent with the person's goals. And it's because, you know, the trainers are coming from multiple places. One, some of them don't know how to train somebody who's 400 pounds or 50 pounds overweight. They're used to training somebody who's in shape and is just trying to be more athletic or whatever. The other thing is, some of these trainers are coming from the standpoint of they want to either weed these people out so they don't have to train them anymore, or they're trying to get them results really fast. And so what they do is they shock the system, right? And I'm not throwing any shade. I did CrossFit before, but I know CrossFit does this. But there are trainers, even in like Gold's, that do this, okay? Like any gym, doesn't matter where, right? They're doing this kind of thing. They're like trying to shock these people to get big results in the first month because they know they only have a few weeks before these people are gonna give up, right? But what they don't realize is that most of the time, the reason why these people are giving up is because these people are like going way insane and they're trying to create these habits, or they're trying to do these workouts without first developing the core habits that one needs in order to do said program. Now, the same thing holds true to diets and programs that people go on themselves without a trainer. It's, you know, they go really extreme, they go balls to the wall without having first developed some core habits. And what happens is they end up scaring themselves or creating so much pain that within the first month, they're terrified to go to the gym anymore and they don't want to go. And honestly, that's, I see it all the time. Like, you'll see this big, fat, overweight dude, and the trainer's like got him running at, I don't know, a 6 or a 7, which for a big dude, that's a lot, for 30 minutes or something. And they're like, they're about to have a heart attack. They're drenched in sweat. And yeah, are they going to lose 10 or 15 pounds in the first week or 2 weeks? Sure. But they're going to be in so much pain and they're going to be so terrified about meeting that every single day that they're never going to come back. And the point of this story is, if you're going to make a resolution, there's nothing wrong with that. That you're coming from a good intent, but be realistic. You have to know yourself. You have to really know who you are and where you're coming from. It's okay to be a beginner. Look, I'll tell you what, going back to my gym experience, back in 2013, my wife was sent on a military assignment, and we were separated for basically a year. And during that time, I took it upon myself. I said, this is the year I get back in shape and I start going to the gym. And ever since then, it's pretty much 2018, so about 5 years, I've gone to the gym consistently pretty much every week. I haven't missed a week, okay? How did I do that? How did I start that? Well, it started out with me going to the gym, and I only would go for about 10 or 15 minutes every other day. I set really low expectations, and the point wasn't to lose weight. The point wasn't to like become super strong or lift a crazy amount. It was just to go down to the gym for 10, literally 10 to 15 minutes. I think even sometimes I went down for 5 minutes. I know that sounds crazy, but here's the thing. I got used to just going to the gym. I got comfortable with it. I got comfortable with the equipment. I got comfortable with the exercises that I felt decent about. The same thing with the program that I started to do back then. I kind of eased into it. I gave myself a couple weeks to kind of get going. And within no time, I built those habits that helped me sustain. Now, and I could go on and on, but the point is, like, now, as I said, I haven't missed a week for 5 years. I've gone to the gym. I'm way stronger than I was. My body composition is extremely different than it used to be, all because I decided to create those baseline habits. Now, having been an athlete in high school and all this other stuff and been in the military, was it kind of disturbing at how weak I felt on those first few days and how little I could run or do whatever exercise on those first few days? Sure. But over time, I was very easily able to get back to where I had been back in my younger years. And it was because I didn't kill myself. I didn't injure myself by trying to overdo it. I didn't scare myself out of the gym by trying to like do crazy exercises or do some diet that was gonna make me go psychologically insane. So that's a real key there, guys. Now, how does this tie into everything else? Maybe your resolution has nothing to do with the gym. Maybe it has to do with writing. Maybe it has to do with speaking. Maybe it has to do with doing investments. Maybe it has to do with like interacting with people or dealing with your family. It could be anything. The question you have to ask yourself is, what can I do to just create a baseline habit right now to make me feel comfortable, to ease me in? And every week or every month, kind of self-assess and see like, okay, where can I go from here? Can I add another 5 minutes to each day? Can I add another day to the week? Can I add another set? Like whatever it is, if you're writing, like can I add another, say, 5 minutes of writing? If it's about speaking, can I go to a speaking event at least 1 day a week or 1 day a month and get comfortable being around people? You know, whatever your goals are, and please feel free to drop them down in the comments below, but whatever they are, you need to consider, like, what are the baseline habits I need to just show up and be consistent? Because at the end of the day, anybody who's successful, it's not because they lift the most or anything out of the gate. It's because they're consistent. There are days I go to the gym and I don't do that much. I'm probably not going to do much today. But because I go every day, there are days where I do great. Like, I'm killing it in there. And it would never happen if I was too afraid to go, or if I'd given up on my resolution that I made years ago. Okay? So think about that, guys. I hope this helps. And if I don't make a video for New Year's, I want to wish everybody a Happy New Year's. Okay, this is Josh signing off. Take it easy.